Listen to Chicago's very own 720 WGN for more.
Some negative performers on Wall Street today.
Only one broadcaster has been on the air longer with the same organization than Orion Samuelson.
Welcome back to This Week in Agribusiness.
For almost four decades, Max Armstrong has been by the side of the Big O.
The knowledge of the industry and the understanding of what farmers want to know, but also what they want to have said about them.
He opened that conference with one of his sweetest jokes, and boy, that went over good.
Farmers like Will McNeil and Pete Tecampi of Grays Lake.
He's done more for agriculture than any one person, as far as I'm concerned, in the world.
He's the news commentator that's always had the farmers' back. He's told our side of the story better than we ever could have thought.
Farmers and ranchers really feel they don't have a voice in national affairs and activities today. They see me as a voice that they don't have.
Orion is Norwegian and grew up on a dairy farm in Ontario, Wisconsin, about 250 miles northwest of Chicago. It was a loving yet hard and primitive life.
There are some dates in your life you never forget. April 11th of 1947, the REA hooked up the Samuelson farm to electricity. When I'm asked today what's the biggest change in technology you have witnessed, I say it's the arrival of electricity on the farm.
Orion has had three major health scares. The first as an eighth grader when he contracted a bone disease and couldn't walk for 2 years. He had a lot of time to listen to the radio. By his senior year, Orion was back on his feet and joined public speaking competitions. He graduated high school and turned down a scholarship at the University of Wisconsin to go to announcer's school in Minnesota. He made headlines when he was hired at a radio station 17 miles from the farm.
I was a polka disc jockey in Sparta, Wisconsin.
Polka disc jockey?
Polka disc jockey.
I didn't know they had polka disc jockeys.
Oh, golly, yeah, they did. I could name them all. Six Fat Dutchman, Romy Gauze and the Gosling, Cousin Fuzzy and the Cousins.
He was working in Green Bay, Wisconsin, when his big break came in September of 1960. WGN Radio in Chicago wanted Orion to be their farm services director.
I thought, boy, I'm in Green Bay, I'm a big fish in a little pond. And then on the other hand, I said, if you get WGN on your resume, you can go anywhere.
In his 53-plus years at WGN, Orion has survived a serious car crash, a business venture called Channel Earth that went bankrupt, and more recently, a life-threatening throat disease. Orion has interviewed presidents and foreign dignitaries, and at one time was on a short list to become the nation's agriculture secretary.
Who would have thought that a dairy farm kid from Wisconsin would have a street in Chicago?
Are we ready?
Ready.
I think we are.
These days, Orion and Max mix speaking engagements with taping their syndicated television program, seen on 150 small market stations across the country.
The compliment that I probably get the most is, thank you for what you have done to keep agriculture in the news in a positive way. I would like to be remembered as a good broadcaster and just a likable guy.
For a guy to be there for 60 years and to be able to tell the story and continue to tell that story says a lot for him, that a lot of people trust him, not just the agricultural community. Happy birthday. You deserve it.
Orion, I hope you appreciate we're standing out here in sub-zero weather. Wish you a happy birthday. They're wishing happy birthday to Orion.